Attorney General Jeff Sessions says there has been a, quote, erosion of confidence in the FBI and the Department of Justice, telling the Washington Examiner, I have believed it was important to have a fresh start at the FBI, and actually it was in my letter to the president when I recommended Comey's removal. I used the words fresh start, and the FBI director is Chris Wray, a very talented, smart, capable leader. Joining me now, Asha Rangappa, CNN legal and national security analyst and former special agent at the FBI. When you hear those words from Jeff Sessions that a fresh start is needed, number one, do you agree? And number two, what does that look like?
Well, it's interesting that he believes there's been an erosion of confidence, since a lot of that erosion has been a result of a lot of the politics that have taken place surrounding the Mueller investigation instead of just letting it continue unimpeded. I don't know what he means by a fresh start. Most FBI agents are civil servants, career civil servants. They're there because they felt a sense of mission, and they have protections. I don't, you know, you can't just fire everybody in the FBI and then hire people anew. And they also have a lot of institutional expertise in their various areas, so it would be a very bad idea for us to do that. I will note, though, Erica, one thing that caught my ear when you were reading that statement is him referencing his letter on why Comey needs to go. Mm-hmm. And I think there could also be a secondary motive of trying to affirm that there were good reasons to fire Comey and not illicit ones that Mueller might be looking into. So just a note there.
And an important note, in terms of the Mueller investigation, there is new reporting this morning, of course, from the New York Times, that the president's attorneys want him to refuse an interview with special counsel Bob Mueller. And this comes on the heels of CNN reporting from last week that the president's attorneys were arguing that the Mueller team hadn't met the high threshold it needed to have a face-to-face interview with the president. This could be pushing things closer to perhaps even a subpoena, despite the fact the president has said he looks forward to sitting down with Robert Mueller. How far do you think this gets pushed?
Well, this particular question of whether the special counsel could compel the president to testify in front of a grand jury hasn't yet been decided. So they could push it all the way to have it legally decided by a court. I think that it's an uphill battle for the president because the criminal process is given very high weight by the court. When there is information that someone can provide, even the president of the United States, they aren't immune from having to participate in that process. What it does, though, Erica, is it buys them time. Listen, if I were the president's lawyers, I wouldn't let him get near Mueller, within 20 feet of Mueller. You just don't want him to talk in an interview to agents, in front of a grand jury, because the likelihood of committing perjury is very high. But this allows them to put it off and avoid some of the political downside of, say, having to take the Fifth Amendment, which would be his other option, and may not look good in the court of public opinion.
We've talked so much over the last several days about the different memos. Obviously now the Democratic memo is in the hands of the president. He will have to decide whether to release that. The New York Times, though, is also, as we're talking so much more about the FISA court and about requests, is requesting to see those documents. These are documents that have never been revealed since, of course, this act was enacted in 1978. And you, in your role, also used to obtain FISA warrants. A, do you think that request by the New York Times would ever be granted? And B, what kind of information could then be out there?
I don't think that request should be granted. This is an ongoing investigation, Erica, and the whole point is that there are multiple sources and methods and investigative tools that have gone into providing the evidence for the underlying affidavit that would have led to a FISA order. So they would not have just relied on the Steele dossier. Some of those are incredibly sensitive. They could be overseas human sources who are in genuine danger if they are outed. So this needs to go through an internal review with, say, the Office of the Inspector General. If there is a true concern that the FBI didn't follow its procedures or didn't provide enough evidence, all of that needs to be done in a secret classified setting with a report that comes out. This is not something that the public can really assess, and it would be bad for our national security for all of that to be released at this point.
Asha, always appreciate your insight on these matters. Thank you.
Thank you.
The moment of truth nearly here.